What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the Tampa Bay Buccaneers franchise. We begin this episode in Dallas for Sunday Night Football as we try to slow down Ezekiel Elliot. I'm not sure how far this episode is going to go. It could go to week 11, maybe week 12, maybe we stop after week 10. I guess we'll see how things unfold. But here against the Cowboys, a team that we very well could be meeting again in the postseason, this should be fun. So currently the Buccaneers are unbeaten at 6-0. Behind us are the Falcons at 4-3, the Saints at 2-4, and the Panthers at 2-4. I think unless there is some major mishap this year that we should be winning this division. And if you look at our remaining schedule, we have a Sunday nighter this week, 49ers next week, Lions, Eagles, the Saints, Panthers, Buffalo, Atlanta, the Giants, and the Falcons to end the year again. So clearly our big challenge this game is going to be slowing down the Cowboys' run offense, which is currently top in the NFL. Ezekiel Elliott running for 130 per game. His stats are just absolutely ridiculous. But we do take on the worst pass offense in the league, which would be great if we weren't a bottom five pass defense. Again, for the third straight year. So one of the big stories from last episode, if you missed it, was George Paulson earning superstar development. He took down Jameis Winston twice against the Patriots, got superstar dev, and is trending upwards pretty quickly. And he's under 400 away from another upgrade, so that should be happening pretty soon and on the road to maybe 90 before next season. Gonna hope that next ability is something for pass rushing, as he's only 22. Defensive Rookie of the Year might be a lock. Also, maybe even Defensive Player of the Year in the NFC, as he's currently behind Myles Garrett and tied with Justin Houston to lead the NFL in sacks right now. We are 34 snaps away from unlocking Parrish Horton's dev trait. We did unlock Khalil Hemingway's development. He's superstar dev, and I don't know how I edited out this portion of the video for the last episode, but right now we obviously don't know his ability. Still 4 overall points away. We have an upgrade ready to go. He's already very good in coverage. And if you thought the upgrading stopped there, you'd be wrong. Eric Armstead's also superstar dev. So I touched on this to end last episode. I'm personally not a big fan of the way that Eric Armstead earned superstar development. George Paulson met his personal game goals. He got 2 sacks, 2 TFLs. Eric Armstead did not get 2 TFLs, did not record a sack at all, did not record a forced fumble, and obviously didn't record any interceptions. We did, however, reach the team goal of not allowing the Saints to run for more than 75 yards and at least more than one rushing touchdown. So for me, I kind of want to take his ability away because he technically didn't earn it. And I want to get some feedback for this, but I think going forward for defensive players, we're just going to go off their player goal and not the overall team goal. Because if you look at an offensive player like Jordan Howard, who needs 3 touchdowns or 150 rushing and receiving, or a mix of both, I don't really think that's fair. I don't. And we are going super try-hard mode for Howard. Starting third down back, starting power back, and obviously our starting primary back, so maybe we reach this goal too. A few big upgrades here. Lane Haynes, the starting right guard, who's only normal development, so getting him upgraded is pretty expensive. We will go pass protector. We get 2 upgrades and 2 finesse and 1 for power. I think for Khalil Hemingway, we'll keep working on hybrid because I think that the abilities are based off of your archetype. So if I can get something for coverage rather than him being a run stopper, that would be great. We do get +1 man and +1 zone. DeMarcus Lawrence is going to be a big problem, but Archer Young should not be facing him this game. We'll go pass protector for him. Still no scheme fit, which is weird, but up to a 73, a little pass block power and a little awareness. So to end last episode, George Paulson recorded 4 sacks against the Saints. Can he do the same here against a very good Dallas front line? Gotta keep Zeke contained and gotta get to Prescott in the backfield. Let's go, Tampa Bay. And here come the Cowboys. DeMarcus Lawrence leads them out the tunnel, and we'll see how much of an impact he plays this game as the Buccaneers take the field. This should be a really entertaining game. top teams in the NFC. A little Sunday night primetime, all these superstars, David Cole, Ezekiel Elliot is going to be a problem. I'm really nervous, especially when you're running for 180 the previous week. Who did they play? That's ridiculous. Buccaneers football to begin the game as David Cole leads the troops on the field. 16 touchdowns, one interception through 7 weeks of action. He's been so good, there's no sophomore slump here in Tampa Bay. This kid's fantastic. And the road to 150 for Jordan Howard begins right now. It'll be a play fake to begin the game. David Cole with good time as he throws this one to the sideline. That's knocked away from Evans. I really like the aggressiveness of going to Mike Evans early, as we saw that against the Patriots, although it didn't connect that time either. Second down, this is Cole, flip out to Howard, all by himself. And it's Howard across midfield to the Cowboys 47. There's 26 yards. So already one-fifth of the way to his goal in the first drive. I don't want to get too ahead of myself, but if this continues to happen, if he's left alone like that, Howard could be superstar dev by halftime. The big question, of course, can we run the football? We will try here on first down, and there's Gabe Clancy, first-round pick for the Cowboys, and he is playing surprisingly well. He's got, what, 6 sacks already this year? And there's a big play against the run. That's Lane Haynes who can't block. So Howard gets 26, loses 3. Now it's Corey Clement in the game at receiver. This throw underneath, and O.J. Howard somehow gets positive yardage. They have got to fix that issue. Tight ends running stick routes. They always run the wrong way. 3rd and 7 now. Another empty look. This time a screen that's going to be set up properly. And there's Howard out of bounds. And a flag down. This is offensive pass interference, because this has been happening quite a bit. And apparently Howard didn't catch the ball in bounds anyway. So this game off to a great start. Pinion's punt from the 45 to the Cowboys 27. What is going on? And here comes Zeke and Dak. Our drive stalls, and here come the Cowboys. Zeke, the lone back, gets Prescott, who will start play action. This ball thrown downfield, and Amari Cooper with the catch. Soft zone coverage right there. Can't have that. And now the Cowboys spreading out the defense from the 42. Another throw for Dak Prescott. This throw to Herndon, who gets across midfield to the 43. So the Cowboys start with 2 throws. Now it's a 3 tight end look. And it's a handoff to Ezekiel Elliott, who bursts through the defense. But this likely coming back. That flag was super early. Unless it's offsides, because of course it is. And George Paulson. This game's off to a fantastic start. Prescott throwing a little RPO there. Nice play call, soft coverage, and Randall Cobb comes through for 10. So now inside our 30, and they are moving to the gun. Maybe another throw here from Dak Prescott. It will be a throw. Check down Zeke. Gets away from the defense. He's got all this speed, and he's down inside the 15. And there's another big play for this Dallas offense. And will Zeke do it here? Not this time. Come on, defense. Make a play here. First down from the 14-yard line. Zeke gets the football, met by Ngakoue. Loss of 1. If we can keep them the 3 points here, I'd be okay with that. Forcing Dak to throw. 3rd and 11. Pressure incoming. Ball floated. Pollard can't handle it. And is picked off by Sean Murphy Bunting. 3rd pick. Of the season, and nearly a pick six. How did Pollard catch him? I'm gonna roll that down to fatigue, but that is a huge play for this defense. And we get the ball back at the 46, right where we had it before. And that's one of those rare times where you see Murphy Bunting's superstar ability tip drill actually activate. That's a great thing to see, because I thought that was pretty useless, but here he goes, making a big play. I am mistaken. We're starting from our 46, not the Cowboys' 46. So 10 yards short. It will be Cole throwing, and this catch made. That is Howard, who is tightly covered by Leighton Vander Esch. That will make it second and one. And what do we decide to do here? Cole under center. Howard is the back, and it will be Cole to throw again. This throw to the sideline. What a catch by Marsh. Seeing a lot of five wide in the first quarter, which I don't necessarily mind. As Cole throws, and Evans can't make the catch. Got sandwiched there between two defenders. Now coming out bunch left on third and seven. David Cole hands off to Jordan Howard. Why run there? And now Howard's hurt. Holding his hip. That's not good at all. Oh, great. And now I'm stuck in this. So this went from a 51-yard field goal to a 56-yarder because I couldn't get out of that screen. So this still should be in gaze range because we're not dealing with wind. From the right hash, kick on the way. Kick is short. I really feel like we're dealing with some kind of wind. Pinius punt. And now that kick being that short, what's going on? This game being tied at zero is really grinding my gears right now. First and 10, another play fake for Prescott. This throw underneath is going not for much. Haven't seen much from the Dallas run game, haven't seen much from us, but here comes Zeke right through the defense. Devin White missed a easy play. And there's something we don't want to see too much this game. Zeke feasting. Let's not let that happen. Getting close to field goal range again. First down, play fake for Prescott. Throw wing, that ball deflected. Sean Murphy bunting there again. Playing really well this year. And it's, what, eight throws, two runs. Wow, their balance is not there. Second down. And just as I say that, it's Zeke again. And then Mike Edwards called for a face mask. We can't let that happen, guys. Might be another run here for Zeke from the 10. Prescott, quick screen. Cooper shoves away the rookie. Oh, come on. Paris Horton, you've got to do better. And the Cowboys take the lead. Wow, that's not a good look. Not a good look at all. That's embarrassing. Mari Cooper doing what he does best, physical receiver. Should have had points our first drive, should have had points our second drive. What does drive number three have for the Buccaneers? And no Jordan Howard, so that's not a good sign as we get this ball across midfield pretty easily. And to start the second quarter, inside the red zone. That pass knocked away. Second down. Evans down to the three. First and goal is O.J. Howard on the board. And we tie the game. So can we slow down Dallas here as they get the ball here in the second quarter? Herndon picks up a big gain. Prescott incomplete. Then Mike Daniels. Pass knocked away. Third down. Zeke for 10. And that was a first. Then a 15-yard penalty. Paulson, come on. That's not how I want to see your name come up. I need a sack here. Second down, Zeke for four. Third down, incomplete. And the Cowboys will tack on three. Riley Mulligan, 49-yarder is good. Really shocked to see 15 throws to five runs for the Cowboys, but I guess they'll try running later on. Here's Marsh in motion. Clement gets the football. That carry is going to lose yards, and we nearly give it back to Dallas. Corey Clement, we can't have that. We are not running well at all. We have got to take care of the football. So that loses five, unfortunately. And now forced to throw here, David Cole. He's got time, taking a shot over the middle. Mike Evans, covered by Jones, but not covered well enough. Third downs have not been our friend today. We only need 2 yards. Let's just make a smart play here. Play fake. Cole throws. This is Marsh, who gets away. Almost didn't get that, but he's got the speed to get outside pretty easily. He is so much fun to watch. Ball at midfield, third down again. Who do we go to this time? David Cole floating this one downfield for Scott Miller, and that ball is nearly picked off. Yeah, if we could not do that to Miller, that would be great, but we stall again. Not good. Got to get these guys off the field. It's Prescott throwing. Good protection, of course, with this offensive line. And Zeke gets a reception, picks up around four. Big third down. Prescott throwing. Catch is made. Oh, it's incomplete. Gallup couldn't squeeze it. Sean Murphy bunting does it again. Locking down that side of the field. So at this point, I am going to assume that Howard is not returning. So there goes superstar Dev. We will start with a little jet sweep here to Mike Evans, who gets away from two defenders. One thing I am doing this game, I am moving Evans around quite a bit. He's now the starting slot receiver, at least when we're watching games. And we're seeing him move around quite a bit, despite it being a three or four wide set, which is pretty cool to see. Seeing this formation quite a bit. Bunch, play fake. Cole, with time, throws Clement. And that is shy of the 40. No Mike Evans on the field this play. Everyone's in tight. It is Higgins, bottom of your screen, and it's going to be a sweep to the tight end. Why? You know what? I can't complain too much. I did put that play in our playbook for second and short, so that's my fault. Here's a third down play fake again, and going outside, O.J. Howard, this time a little redemption, and inside the 10, down to the 9. I don't know why, but play action's been really good for us today. We've got to keep that going here. One safety rolls down, one safety deep. What do we do here on first and goal? David Cole will throw. That is Howard, and he doesn't get too far. If we could not run against this look, that'd be great. Second down from the 4. Play fake. Blitz incoming. Blitz picked up. David Cole to the end zone. Mike Evans on the board with the touchdown. His 5th of the season. That play call, pretty good. Play action's been great today. Protection's been there. That corner had no idea what was going on. Look at this kid. That's Mike Evans we're talking about. That's his superstar ability too. Big play. Good drive from the offense. We take the lead with 1:30 left, but our 2-minute defense has been really bad this year, and this throw to Zeke is somehow caught. Tight coverage by Khalil Hemingway, though, so that's not going for much. Second down, Prescott throwing, and that is nearly picked off, and there we go again, Mike Edwards. Can't have that. That's a 3-15 on the face mask, and they get this ball to the 42. Cowboys have not done a lot of testing deep. They've really been working underneath, which is why these linebackers need to step up. Here's a throw outside to Amari Cooper. Wow, what a catch by Cooper that time. And apparently, I set the corners to cover based on overall, but that is not happening here. So here goes third down. This throw is caught. That's Randall Cobb to the 30, first down. And that's the issue with all these underneath throws. We can't get pressure quick enough. Paulson's almost gotten there a few times. And we have got to cover Zeke out the backfield. And this clock goes down to 16 seconds, and the Cowboys call a timeout. Oh, that's smart. They're going to take their 3 points here. No timeouts remaining. And Riley Mulligan from 35. That kick is good. And this ball game down to a 1-point lead. Dallas Cowboys offense on the field, down by one here to start the second half, and they have not run the ball well, although they haven't really tried. Another play fake here, and Herna gets away from David in man coverage. We can't have that. That is a liability. If someone's blitzing, let it be David. Let White cover, please. 24 passes, only 6 runs. It is absolutely not what I thought we see, and there goes a sack for Vea. They tried going screen, and Vea gets his first sack of the year in week 8. Defense, get off the field here. 3rd and 14. Gave up a few of these to the Patriots last go around. This throw to Cooper. Oh, Hargreaves nearly blew that play. Good tackle there. He took a bad angle first, but kept the 4th and 3. David Cole in the zone to begin the second half. Can we get points here? It'll be a handoff to Clement, and he runs into a brick wall. Jalen Smith and Leighton Vander Esch. We're getting a Boise State player on this team eventually, whether we have to draft or sign one in free agency, but it's going to happen at some point. But first, I would love to run the ball for more than 11 yards in one half a play. And there's Clement on the reception this time, up to the 28-yard line. Another 3rd and short for the offense. Mike Evans, top of your bunch, and a throw here to Evans. He gets across the 35, and there's a big first down for the Buccaneers. Mike Evans staying busy. Fifth grab, 45 yards. This is really soft coverage from the Cowboys, and David Cole will throw again. Oh, pressure coming in. Good blitz pickup, and there's a catch for Godwin. Actually, that wasn't a blitz. That was just a defensive end getting around Archer Young, who has not given up a lot of pressure this game. First and 10, this time a give to Clement, best run of the game. And there's more yards there than he's had on his first six. I'll take it. This is Jamison Martian motion. Mike Evans slot left, and a give to Clement on the sweep. He somehow gets through traffic, and a hard-earned 4 yards. David Cole throwing on second down, of course, and a catch made by Marsh over the middle. First down, Buccaneers. When this offense gets going, it's hard to stop. Run again for Clement up to the 20, and that is Jalen Smith who gets hurt. That's a big blow for their defense, especially their run defense. Single high look for the Cowboys on second down. David Cole under pressure. Here comes Lawrence right on time. And we're backed up to third and 15. That was going to happen at some point. Looks like press coverage on the outside. Just give Cole time to make a play. Cole resets. Pressure incoming. Floats one. Two. Ricky Seals Jones. And no flag down. What just happened? Down to the 8-yard line. Cole gets crushed by Lawrence. And Vander Esch too aggressive in coverage. That is clutch. 8 yards away from the end zone, Corey Clement gets a break. Armon Hunter checks in. And a run here with Hunter to the left on the counter, and that's not going far. A lot of press coverage here from the Cowboys. Hunter left side again and met, and that is good for round 3. So third and goal. And this is an empty look for the Buccaneers. Mike Evans slot left. And it's Cole looking for someone downfield. Lawrence incoming again. Down goes Cole. Lawrence gets his second sack of the game. He is in the zone, and we will be forced to settle for 3 points here. And I can't spot this play. I think it was stick, but Marsh ran a hitch, and he might have had Clement there for a second, maybe. So at least we get 3 points, and we'll head back to Super Sim here late in the third quarter, see what the Cowboys can do on offense, and that is not what we want to see. Another 15-yard penalty, and then a sack for Armstead. So assuming all these are face mask calls, I don't like how this is going, and they do stall here. And oh boy, that's big. Armstead's hurt, start of the fourth quarter. They went for it? What? There are some crazy things happening in this game, and we're down by 3 here. And there's Leighton Vander Esch with a sack, and 3rd and 12, we get a first. Corey Clement for 15. And then Byron Jones helps out. We get this ball across midfield. So hopefully finding a way to at least tie the game here. But there's O.J. Howard to the 19. Hunter finds 1, then 4 for Hunter. 3rd down, and Tristan Hill with a sack. We are backed up to the 19, and Matt Gay's 36-yarder is good. I mean, they've got to go to Zeke at some point this game, right? Oh, speak of the devil, tossed outside. That run is shut down, and Zeke is hurt. Holding his shoulder. That could be huge. That does bring Pollard back in the ballgame. 2nd and 15. Dak Prescott throws to Cooper. What a catch again. Not for much, though. And now a 3rd and 9. And this coverage is really soft, so I doubt we're going to blitz. Actually going to bring 1. Devin White blitzing again. Throw from Prescott is way off the mark. Now is not the time to get fancy. We'll run here, and it's Hunter who's met, and he does not get far. 5 carries, 9 yards. So neither him or Clement having much success, although our run game is almost on pace with the Cowboys' run game. 2nd and 9. That is Chris Godwin in motion. Cole throws. Catch made. Marsh to the 19. And no, Marsh is hurt too. That does bring Rashard Higgins in the ball game. So our starting 3 is still pretty solid at receiver if this ends up being long term. And this throw outside immediately goes to Higgins. first down catch. We just need one of those drives where we take time off the clock and get this ball in the end zone. 5:30 left. We run with Hunter, who gets this down to the 38. What is this coverage, though? Second down, pump fake Cole throwing left. This ball is caught by Chris Godwin. Cole now at 351, and Godwin's got 84. 4:35 to go. Defense is spread out. Can we run the ball down their throat? Oh, that was actually a blitz. Never mind. Good play call again. There's Evans to the 25-yard line. And they actually didn't have Byron Jones covering Evans that time, so moving him around is working out a little better than I thought it would be. Lined up against number 25 again. I forgot his name, but clearly he can't cover Evans. And that's the matchup that I want to keep going after. Right, it's Woods, who is obviously not very good in coverage, so we got to keep going at him. Although Mike Evans is lined up at the top of your screen this time, and Byron Jones is there. It is off coverage. It will be a run here to Hunter, who's planted by Van Der Esch. Down to the final 4 minutes of the ball game. This drive going pretty well as Chris Godwin in motion now. David Cole throwing. This is Godwin who gets away from one, and Godwin does move the chains down to the 10. Maybe leaving too much time for Dallas as Cole reaches 2,000 yards. So what's the play call here in the red zone? First and goal. Cole throws. That is Marsh who's back in the ball game. And he's down to the 2, so 8 yards that time. And hopefully we can find a way to punch this in as we come out 5 wide. Just take care of the football here. This could be another blitz from Dallas. They will bring both linebackers. Cole throws in zone and picked off. No, Byron Jones. Oh, no, David, why? Who was that 2? That is not good. Cole looking for either Miller or Clement. Why? That's not what we wanted. And Dallas has all 3 timeouts, 2:45 to go. We're in a little trouble here. Come on, defense, let's end this game. So they ran for 5 on first down. What do they do here on second down? It'll be another run, and is Prescott on the option? Wow, we haven't seen that since last year, I think. Down to the 2-minute warning, and Prescott blitzing coming. Pass off in time. It's Gallup who gets away, and they're in our territory now. This soft coverage against slants has been an issue all season. Prescott all day to throw. First down, check down, and that is Pollard to the 39. Got to find a way to stop them here. Now they're going heavy. Come on, defense, bring pressure. Pollard gets it, runs right through the defense. And now we have to call a timeout because they're in field goal range. David Cole has been great this entire series, but might have just cost us the game, although our run defense is not helping us right now either. Second down and 2, and down to our final timeout. I can't believe Tony Pollard might put this game away. He will indeed. This ball is down to the 15, and there's our final timeout. This honestly is the biggest downside of this series, and really the bigger issue I had with putting this playbook together for the defense is that I can't make play calls based on situations. It's based on personnel, and there's another run. At this point, you got to let them score. Got to let him score. Third down, Pollard gets it, runs through the defense. They listen to me. That at least gives us a chance to tie the game. Although, they shouldn't have been able to get down here in the first place. Defense has to play better. Kick return touchdown for Marsh would be a great way to take this game to overtime. He starts from the 5 across the 25. Spin to make a defender miss and couldn't quite get through the gap there. So we start from the 31 with 16 seconds, and time for Cole to make a big play here. So did Corey Clement get hurt too? Because Hunter should not be out here as the primary third down back, but first and 10, Cole with time as they only rush 3. That pass caught. He gets away from Van Der Esch and gets out of bounds. All right, that's down to the 47 at least. Okay, so Clement is good to go, and we have 3 receivers bottom of the screen. And the Cowboys only rush 3 with 8 seconds left. Good protection. Cole looking downfield. This ball into traffic and no one made a play there. So now down to the final 2 seconds. Perfect season on the line. Cowboys rush 3. Protection holds up again. Actually, never mind. Clancy gets through. This ball is intercepted out of bounds. And there is the ball game. We fall in week 8 to the Cowboys. Really disappointing game this week. Offense had, 3 drives that ended up resulting in no points. And we had a few drives that went down the field. And we had to settle for field goals a lot due to DeMarcus Lawrence and his pressure. So, I'm sure we'll see this team again, but wow, the second half was not very good, only 6 points. Well, you hate to see it, but David Cole's second pick of the year comes at the wrong time and ruins what was otherwise a pretty solid game. 400 yards, 75% passing, 2 scores, could have been 3. Just a really rough ending. Obviously, Zeke didn't finish, but for the most part, I feel like we kept him pretty contained. Corey Clement, 32 yards, 3.5 a carry. Pollard, man, we have got to play better run defense late in the game. And obviously, I can't do much to fix that with the way the playbook is set up. And Howard, yeah, we're not getting superstar dev. Best game of the year for O.J. Howard. 8 grabs, 85 yards and a score. Marsh, 55. Godwin, 95. Evans, 61. Clement, 31. Higgins, 13. Hunter, Seals, Jones, and Howard started off with a bang. I don't want to sound rude, but this defense is really getting on my nerves, especially Mike Edwards. Those 2 face mask calls were so horribly timed. Devin White, 6 tackles, 1 for a loss, and Gakwe, 3 tackles for a loss this game. Overall, we had quite a few, which I was happy with. Can't say the same for the sack production. Vaez was a bit of a fluke. Armstead had 1, so could have been better. It all came down to that last drive. The game was so close. Obviously, the run game leaves a lot to be desired again, but Dallas's front line was pretty good. Both teams had a turnover this game. We were 5 of 10 on third downs, and that 1 red zone trip. A field goal would have been great, but not today. So Howard went from holding his hip on the field to walking off the field holding his wrist to now having broken ribs. Luckily, not long term, but our medical staff, what's going on? So with Howard out, Clement obviously becomes the starter, then Armon Hunter the backup, and Ronald Jones is third. And then Parrish Horton has star dev. Obviously, that really embarrassing touchdown. Not the best look for the rookie, but star dev should hopefully help him get his man coverage up. Maybe his tackling, because 73 and 62, not very good. Wow, this could be another potential playoff matchup. We meet the 49ers on the road this week, and hopefully they don't give us our first losing streak of the year. Now is not the time to start falling apart, guys. Vea gets his first sack of the season. Let's try to build a little momentum here. We're going to try a new contract offer. He rejected 4 years, 27.1. The salary was a little low. We're going to bump this up to a 4.8 base at 4 years, 28.7. Vea does accept. So he's on for 4 more years. And this defensive line class is pretty good, so big boost there. Sean Murphy Bunting got a pick. He gets an upgrade. George Paulson did not have a great game. He gets an upgrade as well. And we'll start with Sean Murphy Bunting. We will stick with the man-to-man coverage. 3 upgrades as he gets plus 1 man, 1 play rec, and 1 awareness. That takes Murphy Bunting up to 88 man coverage. Got to keep Paulson's eyes on the prize and finish the year strong. We're in the second half now. And we could go power. We could maybe go block shed, but I want to keep him focused on his speed rushing finesse, and we will go that route here. 3 upgrades for Paulson, 1 finesse, 1 pursuit, and plus 2 for awareness. Upgrade here for Carlton Davis, who's our 4th stringer since we brought in Jimmy Smith. He gets, 5 upgrades. 2-man coverage. Okay. Backup guard Matthew DeMarco. I think we're going to go a different route here. Let's go agile. Why not? So no overall bump. We get 3 upgrades, plus 2 pass finesse, and 1 for run. So I'm going to be honest here. This draft class is not very good. Defensive line's really deep. We know that already. Everything else really questionable. And here I am halfway through the year scouting quarterbacks, trying to find a backup for David Cole. And we might have one here in Andrew Wagner, the 21-year-old out of Baylor with A-plus throw power, B-plus mid, and B-short accuracy. Mid-third rounder with mid-second round talent, or maybe we try to wait a little bit longer and go to Miles Nowak, the scrambler from OK State. A throw power, A-minus short, B-plus mid. Another good option, but a little concerning that his talent is behind his projected draft place. We take down San Francisco 27-17, and the defense playing a lot better this week. And our run game a lot better this week as well. That's a great sign, which we could have seen that last week. We did force a turnover. We were 4-4 in the red zone. San Fran 2-4 in time of possession. Pretty telling. Good game by the defense. David Cole throws for 276 and 3 scores. Jimmy G throws for 212 and was sacked 3 times by this Buccaneers pass rush, and both quarterbacks threw pretty poorly, 62%. Coleman with 72 yards, average a bit concerning. Corey Clement 3.7, Hunter 4.6, and David Cole nearly 20. Not a bad game for the receivers. Evans 92 and a score. Godwin 62 and a score again. OJ Howard 45, Clement 41, Seals Jones 25, Marsh only 11. Levante David, 8 tackles, 2 for a loss, not bad. Devin White 7-1 for a loss, Vernon Hargreaves 6. Edwards had a pick this game, could have used one of those against Dallas. Tackles for loss, we had 7, and sacks on the game. Ngakoue Ansah, not bad. Jimmy Smith and Eric Armstead split 1, so 3 by the defense, I like it. And Paulson, only 3 tackles and 1 for a loss this game. No sacks, back-to-back weeks. Uh-oh, we've got 2 breakout scenarios to work through here. Chris Godwin and someone else, along with an injury decision for Howard, I would assume. So Godwin appreciates getting the ball. He has been fairly involved. It's been one of his best years as a Buck. And why is it the same goal as it is for running backs? I mean, he had 3 scores against Miami earlier this year, and superstar dev's a big deal, but that's a little unfair for the receivers. So that's one, and the other player, I don't know who this would be for, it is Corey Clement. Wow, 1 game as a starter, it wasn't like it was great, but a chance for him to move up to star dev. And he needs 2 scores or 100 yards rushing, receiving, which could happen against the Lions. And obviously, with a high chance of re-injury for Howard and Clement with a chance to move up in development, we're not going to bring Howard back. We'll let him sit, see if Corey Clement can reach his goal. And the only upgrade before we take on the Lions is for backup tackle Connor Lewis. He does get 3 upgrades here, 2 for finesse and 1 for power. Oh, and by the way, Levante David has a knee cartilage tear, so he's out for 4 weeks. Howard will obviously be back next week, but this is a little concerning, although it gives another player a chance to play. Mack Wilson getting his shot here in the starting defense, 70 overall. I did trade for him as a potential starter. He's 23 years old. He's got good speed. Coverage is decent. Play rec needs a lot of work, but an opportunity like this for him could be really valuable. Solid traits overall, really solid player, just gonna hope he doesn't become a liability. And we just lost to the Detroit Lions, and our pass defense again not playing great. 337 given up through the air this game. Both teams had a turnover. Third downs were okay. Both teams were 100% in the red zone. I expect better from us. Holy sackapalooza. What happened this game? Stafford 337, 2 touchdowns, 1 pick. Cole adds 2 more touchdowns but throws his 3rd pick of the season. I don't know what happened here. Hopefully no injuries to the offensive line, and both quarterbacks threw pretty decently, although gotta be better. Well, safe to say we did not get the dev trade increase for Corey Clement, who was the starting back in all three roles, and I'm not sure how Hunter got the ball as much as he did. Maybe Clement got hurt. Jones had 12. David caught a rushing touchdown, his first, I think, ever. That's kind of cool to see. Mike Evans has really picked up the pace these past few weeks. 97 yards and another score. Unfortunately, behind him, not much. What happened this week? Higgins had 21. Marsh only 8 yards. Devin White, busy day. 11 tackles, 1 for a loss. Hemingway, 8. Hargreaves, 7. Edwards, 6. Tackles for a loss. We had another big bunch. I like seeing that kind of production, especially from the newly paid man, Vita Vea. 2 sacks this game. And Ngakoue with 1. Paulson had 1. So officially in double digits as a rookie. That's kind of crazy. Daniels and Noah Spence also had 1. Interception went to Mac Wilson. All right, 3 tackles, 1 pick. Way to make an impact or first start. So we lose again. Dallas wins 6 in a row. And now they're the top seed in the NFC. Obviously, a long season left to go. NFC South, we are still leading this pretty heavily. Falcons, Panthers, and the Saints all lost this week. So you never know what's going to happen these final couple of games, but things looking pretty good for us. Another starter hurt on defense, Vernon Hargreaves, missing 3 weeks with a shoulder tear for a secondary that's already not playing great. Now it's Jimmy Smith, who is thrown into the starting role as our starting slot corner, but that's why he's here. And obviously these breakout scenarios did not go very well. Not the best game for Chris Godwin, and obviously Corey Clement did not have a great game either. I don't know what happened with him. He was a starting back in all three roles. He should have had at least 1 rushing touchdown this game. It feels like it's taken forever, but another upgrade here for Yannick Ngakoue, who's trying to get to 90. It won't happen this year unless he somehow comes away with some crazy award. I think a Pro Bowl is in store for him, but 89 overall now. And we get +1 finesse, +1 zone, +1 pursuit, and +2 awareness. Anthony Feliciano with an upgrade this week as well. I can't wait to have to re-sign all these great players in 2 more years. Feliciano, pass protector upgrade. We get a little pass block and finesse and power, +1 for all 3, and then 1 for awareness. So, still waiting for that big pass block bump, but that's not bad. Pretty good ratings. It's been a rough stretch of weeks for second-year receiver Jameson Marsh, who really shouldn't be struggling with those ratings. I mean, this is his best year, obviously. Didn't play much last year because Higgins was unstoppable, but doubling yards, gotta find some more end-zone production. Catching traffic is the big thing I want to work on here. Also, just base catching, because why not? Up to an 80 overall now, stays the scheme fit, 5 upgrades, and he gets catching traffic, catching short route running, and acceleration. So already the fastest receiver on the team, 93 speed, 91 excel, 95 agility. That's why he's always open. So the plan was to stop this episode here, then pick up next time against the Eagles, but they're 2-7. And as much as I want to watch this game to see the rookie receiver, Gilbert Robinson of the Eagles, I think what I likely or prefer to do is send this game and pick up next week when we play the Saints in primetime at home. That could be a really fun game to watch, although they're not doing very well. And there is the kind of performance you expect against a team that is struggling. We beat the Eagles 38-10 offensively. Pretty good game. We ran well. We passed well. Howard is obviously back. Forced a turnover this game. Third downs were a bit low. But no red zone trips allowed for the Eagles this game. That is, I think, the first time our defense has done that in this series. Another clean game for David Cole. 262. 2 scores. Only sacked once. Wentz had 1 score. 1 pick. Was sacked twice. And Cole throwing 78%. And Wentz only 62%. That's what I want to see. Howard's first game back, 4.8 a carry. Gallman, 2.8. Sanders, 4.6. Clement had a score. David Cole ran for another rushing touchdown. I wish we saw this more often in games, because he doesn't run at all. Wait, what the heck? Why does Ryan Tannehill have one run and three broken tackles? Who is he, Marshawn Lynch? 13 receptions, 134, and a score for Godwin this week. Evans, 3 for 54, and another score. Clement, 31. And then after that, I mean, what happened? O.J. Howard, 2 for 16. What is going on with him this year? It's been really inconsistent. Miller had a catch this game, but nothing for Marsh or Higgins? He's the fifth stringer. Okay, Mac Wilson, I see you. 10 tackles, 1 for a loss. He took over this game. That's pretty cool to see, although Devin White only 3 is a bit concerning. Edwards 7, Hemingway 7, Vea 4 and 1 for a loss. Not bad. Tackles for loss as a defense. Another good game. Can't complain. Armstead 2 for a loss and sacks on the game. One from Daniels and another one from Paulson. Now 11.5. And that is interception number 4 for Sean Murphy bunting this season, which I think leads the league. So maybe a Pro Bowl for him this year. So the Saints lost again. They're now 4-5-1. We're 8-2. And I think this will likely be a watch between the Saints or the Bills. And right now I'm kind of leaning towards Buffalo. They're not having a great year, but both of these games are in primetime. At home, we do have a Thursday nighter against the Falcons on the road. That'll be a game we watch for sure. Because I don't think near the end of the year we're really going to be focusing on any big matchups. So I would like to watch at least one division game, maybe two a season. And I don't know if I want to watch this one, but we will see, I guess. And we've got a few upgrades to kick off next episode. Devin White, who I won't say has been a disappointment. I'm a bit bummed he only had 3 tackles and Wilson went off for 10, but we've got a lot of work to do with him still. He has tied his mark for tackles for loss. I would like to see him get a little more involved in pass coverage, so a few interceptions would be great to end the year. And tackling, I don't know if he's going to meet his mark from last year. And that was a mark that got him to the Pro Bowl. So, we got to see more from Devin White in these final couple of games for sure. And that is another Tampa Bay Buccaneers franchise episode in the books. I can't imagine that we won't be learning our playoff fate next episode. This division is clearly ours, especially if we win this game. So catch you all next time. Hope you enjoyed. Have a nice day. See you later.